So it kind of brought up a question for me, and I actually got a tweet a couple days ago where somebody sent me their lineup, and it just was a whole lot of like either out because of injury or on a bye, to the point that it looked like it was going to be tough for them to field a roster. In fact, here it is. So they've got Justin Herbert on a bye, CeeDee Lamb on a bye, Mike Williams on a bye, Austin Ekeler on a bye, Najee Harris, Dawson Knox, James Robinson on a bye. They have Dak Prescott as their other quarterback. So literally their whole starting lineup is on a bye this week. If you found yourself in a situation like that, how would you handle that?
I would take the L this week.
Yeah.
Like, because the thing is, you're not playing fantasy football to win in week seven. I understand it's gonna suck having to watch your team give you like 50 points this week and you're gonna lose and it's not gonna be fun. But I would rather that and have that lineup the rest of the way. That's also a way you could look at it. Like, not only do you want to have these good players on your roster come the end of the year, but you get all your buys out of the way. It's pretty much a bye week for you.
Right.
Go out and enjoy your Sunday. You don't have to, obviously you're going to watch football, but you don't have to be watching your live scoring and your fantasy team and stuff. And then the rest of the way, while everyone else is still dealing with buys, there's buys up until week 14 this year.
Yes.
You do not have to worry about it. So I would just sit tight with those players that you have. I wouldn't be trying to make a trade because no one is going to give you full value being like, hey, I now have to sit all of these players this week for me.
Right.
The only way I would change that stance is if I'm sitting at like 2-5 or something like that and I'm desperate for a win, then I don't think you could just take a loss this week. But if you're like 3-3 or better, it's okay. It's just 1 week. I think you hold on to those players.
Yeah, I think that's the best way to handle it because, you know, you're talking about if you're trying to play waivers, then, you know, obviously that means you're letting go of somebody really good that you don't
Yeah.
want to put back on the waiver wire. If you're trading, it really is just sort of a 1 week fix kind of thing. You know, that roster in particular is just loaded from top to bottom.
Yeah.
So you just sort of sit tight and you take the L this week and you don't worry about it. And I know, you know, I heard from people who were like, well, that just means you drafted poorly. And I'm like, I don't know. I feel like I don't really worry about bye weeks when
Me
I'm
neither.
drafting. I just want to get good players.
Especially if the bye week is, you know, like week seven, that's 2 months since you drafted. So much could change
Right.
in that span. Those players could get hurt. You could make moves. Who knows? So I'm just like you. Like, I think in like a super flex league, maybe you could look at like your second quarterback's bye, so it's not the same as the first. But even so, like, I just said I have Allen and Herbert. I don't regret having those two at all. It'll
Right.
stink this week, but it'll be fine after that.
Yeah. So I mean, look, if you found yourself in that situation, yeah, just take the L. Just take a Nevis for this week, and you know, let it ride, and you'll come back strong next week. And like Florio said, you're done with buys at that point, at least for all your key players, and then you can just roll through to the rest of the regular season.